What is going on, guys? Welcome to the video and welcome to competition day. As you can see, it's just perfect weather. So it is currently 9:51. Because we're in the higher weight class, we don't actually have to weigh in till like 11:30 or 12. We don't go on till 1. Our buddy Johnny is lifting in the lower weight class, so he's going up like right now. We're competing at the shop gym, which we've trained at before. It's pretty packed. There's nowhere to park. I'm super wet. That's what she said. And by the way, you know the last video I said I wear small underwear? I feel like I got thong on my butthole. First thing you do at a powerlifting meet is you check in and then you get your equipment checked. Now obviously this is more of a local meet, it's not a national level, so they kind of let a couple things slide, such as like, you know, specific singlets or whatnot. As long as you're not using an assisting singlet or you're not using like knee wraps, really the vendor doesn't matter. So we have our knock-a-knee sleeves, we're using our chucks, our squat, and our bench. We have our ever forward singlet. We have our knee high socks to protect ourselves from the getting blood on the bar for the deadlift. And then of course we have our 10 millimeter Enzer forever lever belt, which is my baby. And now we wait around for like 3 hours.
No straps?
Not using any.
Tighty whities or boxers?
Tighty whities.
Good. Write your name.
All right, so it is currently 12:09. We're doing weigh-ins. Now, if you were in this higher weight class, the 83 kg, and you were like right on the edge of making weight, it would suck to weigh in right now because that means you have to go the entire morning without anything because you're right on that edge. Living on the edge! But for us, we don't really care, right? I'm only gonna be like 174 pounds. I even have been eating and drinking Gatorades and whatnot, so my weight's probably gonna be a little higher, which will affect my Wilk score, which is, you know, your body weight and relativeness to. Cameraman just got dripped on. The roof just pissed on you, dude. It's like R. Kelly up there. Anyway, we don't really care. We're just gonna try to beat our total of 1400 and we're gonna try to hit some PRs. So I'm eating all the foods. I'm probably not even gonna strip down to my undies. And I think the underwear that I bought is actually a little like, it's like more thongy than everyone else's. I think I got the wrong one. I think I got you like the party underwear? Trying to get like, trying to hit like a big bench or something.
Well, yeah, you're bulking up though, right?
Not by choice. The internet tells me what I have to do these days. All right, so it's 2 o'clock. I need to start warming up for squat, but you see the first problem with competitions is that there's a ton of people trying to warm up. Everyone warms up differently at different speeds and different weights. So you have to kind of like adjust the way that you get ready for a top set differently in a competition setting. So your warm up may be faster than normal, maybe a lot slower than normal. You may like finish your warm ups and then wait like 10 minutes before you step on the stage, or you might be done. It's like 30 seconds. So there's just a lot of things to go into it. It's a lot different than when you're at your home gym, but we're gonna try to work in with someone. Our first squat is, so prime example, we were supposed to start at 2, it is now 2:30. I only have 2 more warm-up reps to go, and we just found out that they're not starting until 2:45. So I have 15 more minutes to wait, and then there's like 8 people ahead of me. So now I need to like wait on my warm-ups, probably do the warm-up again, and then go up closer to it, so. It is now 2:45. We just got word that it could be another 10 to 20 minutes.
Sick,
dude. Warm-up's done. It kind of sucked having to do them like 3 times and then all together, but first attempt, let's go.
How much time we got?
And that's a good squat for Joel.
Max.
And Jonathan Russell.
Can these little knees do it, dude?
And that's a good bit for Brian. We got Philip Foster coming up on platform one, opening up their squat with 170 kilos.
God. So at the very end of that, I like had a little shift, but apparently we did it, dude. These small knees, man. All right, so our first attempt on bench is gonna be 132.5 kilograms, which is 292 pounds. So our final warm-up will be 275. I'm very, very happy we went 3 for 3 on the squats, because if you do really well in the first lift, it's gonna carry over like motivation to continue to do well. So keep that mindset right. Let's do it.
Max Chewy, platform number 2, first attempt, 131.5 kilos.
Start! Rest! Rack!
Nice job, Max.
Attempt 1 went well, feeling confident. Next up, 137.5 kg, 303 pounds!
Platform number 2,
second attempt. Press. Go. All right, guys, we're gonna go for it. 314.2 pounds, 142.5
kg.
Let's go, baby.
142.5 kilos. Zachary on platform number 1, his last attempt at 142.5 kilos as well. Oh,
wait, way to go. It only took me like 7 years, man. This is the happiest day of my life. And what's great is you guys still have to watch my channel because we have not hit 315 yet. You gotta stick around for at least another year. This is probably the happiest that I'm gonna be until January 12th. Woo!
Okay, so
235.
They say the meet does not start until the weight hits the floor, aka the deadlift is like the main event. It is currently 7:15 at night. I've been here since 9:45 in the morning. Just like I say, lube up your body at nighttime. We just kind of lube up our legs before deadlifts. The idea behind that is so if it gets caught on any part of your body, it just kind of slides up.
Go, Rex! Come on! Easy! Down!
Good lift for Christian, and a good lift for Mallory.
Hard body!
Let's go!
Come on! Here's the bag, boy! Go!
Come on, Max.
Come on. Wait. Oh! Oh! Down!
Easy money.
All right, that went well. I'm gonna play it smart on this one. I wanna go 9 for 9, so we're gonna do 627 pounds, which will be a PR, both conventional and sumo.
Yeah.
Let's do it for dude.
Let's get it.
Let's go.
Let's make some noise.
First place, Max Jury. Open 83 class, Ryan Larson.
All right, guys, so we hit some lifetime PRs. We hit some meat PRs. We went 9 for 9. We didn't get hurt. And on top of all that, little icing on the cake. Not really the exact reason why I came here, but we did place first. So I want to give a huge shout out to all my friends that came out to support me, to help film, take photos, just be here, cheer me on. I want to give a huge shout out to my coach, Brett Gibbs, for getting this potato super, super strong. And I want to thank all of you for the kind, positive words and feedback you've given me over this entire prep. Hopefully I motivated a lot of you to get into powerlifting, to be strong. Maybe you're a smaller guy like me, you got small knees, and you're like, man, I can't get jacked, but I can sure as hell get strong. Thank you guys. And we go to Texas in like 5 days. See you later, man.